Hey coaches, it's Amber Turner here from Havre, Montana, and today I'm going to be talking about one-on-one coaching, specifically on the 24-day challenge and staying organized. So before you get anyone started on a challenge, it's really important to know their goals and their lifestyle. But today I really want to focus on staying organized with your challengers, especially when you have them starting on all different days. When I first got started, I didn't have small groups, large groups. I didn't have a lot of people starting on the same day. I had a challenger here, a challenger there. And with my busy schedule, it was really important to me to stay organized so I could help my challengers have the best results possible. So I picked up the follow-up binder method, and that's what I want to talk about today. So I had a follow-up binder specifically for 24-day challengers, and I had the coaching checklist printed off, a bunch of blank ones, from your microsite. If you haven't seen that, you should check it out. It's really great. It tells you exactly what days to follow up, what questions to ask. It's just a really great tool to use. So inside my binder, I have 31 different dividers here, and they're labeled 1 through 31, and that corresponds to each day of the month. So with all my blank coaching checklists ready to go, each time I had a challenger, I would just start filling one of those out. So at the top, I'd put their name. On the back, I could put their goals, any notes that I needed. I would put what start date that they were going to be starting on. So just as an example, if I have a challenge, Sarah here is going to be my example. I would put Sarah's start date here. So Sarah's going to be starting on today, May 6th. So I write May 6th here, and then I fill out all the other dates corresponding to what date I need to follow up with her. So we do the prep call, we get her prepared for the challenge and everything like that. But then I put her in the sixth section of my binder because she's starting on the sixth. So she's in my sixth section. Each day I open up my binder and I look at the corresponding day to see who I need to follow up with. So on May 6th, I open it up and I see that Sarah's on day one and I need to follow up with her. So I follow up with her. It tells me exactly what questions to ask. And then I go ahead and just check it off so I can stay organized and know that I followed up with her. And then it tells me what day to follow up with her next. So what I do is just go ahead and take this follow-up sheet out of that section, the sixth section, and I'm going to move it to the corresponding day three for Sarah, which for her is going to be May 8th. So I'm going to go ahead and just move her to the eighth section. And then on May 8th, when I open up that section, I know to follow up with her. It's her day three. Here's the questions I need to ask her. So this is just a really helpful method if you have a lot of challengers starting on different days, because every day you're going to open it up and know exactly what day they're on, what questions you need to ask. And it's just a, like I said, really helpful tool to stay organized. But if you're brand new, it's a great learning tool for yourself to become the best coach possible. So if you have any questions about the follow-up binder or the coaching checklist, post them in the comments below. I'd love to answer them. And I'm just so excited to be a part of this. Thank you for watching, and I can't wait to just keep learning from all these other amazing coaches. So have a great day.